Alrighty, well, let's play first. See if this goes a little better. I like this hand. This hand's pretty good. I've got misstep to fight other missteps, probe to see what I'm dealing with, and then a bunch of preordains, which is really where this deck wants to be against like the gift style deck. Because it does have, you know, four dig through times and two besages, so let's go ahead and lead off with Gitaxian Probe. That'll help me value my preordain, the cards I see off preordain a little better. My opponent's hand is very soft to mental misstep. Does have Ancestral Preordain and Pyroblast. So Ancestral Preordain, Pyroblast, Fastbond Jace, Mana Drain. So my opponent's likely going to lead with Preordain to try to have a turn 2 Ancestral plus Pyroblast up. So here's where I would not mind seeing mental missteps. I think I'm going to get Underground C because Oath of Druids doesn't do that much without Forbidden Orchard anyway. So looking for more mental missteps. Lotus Show and Tell would be nice. I've got to keep at least a land. I guess I'm slightly better off keeping Scalding Tarn. I don't have to keep the land there, but I think this way I can play land next turn. I could, and I have this option of misstepping the preordain and then demonic tutoring for misdirection. And then if my opponent misses on lands, I get to misdirect ancestral. That is a pretty risky line of play, but I have to decide now. Well, actually what I could do is I could, no, this is even better. I let preordain resolve and then I demonic tutor for misdirection anyway. And my opponent has to have found a red producing land and a force of will to stop the misdirection from happening, because I get to mental misstep the ancestral. My opponent's going to pyroblast that, and then I'm going to go ahead and misdirect it. So we'll see in a second here if that's what ends up happening. And all right, no other plays. All right, and my opponent put both cards on top, so that's not great news for me. Ooh, interesting. I might actually just preordain here, because if I hit a blue card, I can still do the same plan, but if because of the Mox Jet, I can still cast a Demonic Tutor. But if I hit other things, I could do something else. All right, well, put this on the bottom, put this on the bottom. Flusterstorm. It's a little less payoff, but I still get to Demonic Tutor for like Show and Tell. So I think this is probably for the best. The risk if it doesn't work seems fairly high, since I'm burning a Demonic Tutor and then the Flusterstorm in this plan. So I think I like doing this here. Alright, Brainstorm. Interesting. So now my opponent has Pyroblast Ancestral in hand, as well as like Mana Drain, Jace, Fastbond, but those are a little less relevant. Kept, I assume, Brainstorm, Scalding Tarn are two of the cards they saw, plus the one unknown. You know, I think I like misstepping that. I think Brainstorm's almost as good as Ancestral when you have dead cards in your hand, and having this fight now is reasonable. If next turn I miss on blue cards, I can hit, I can Demonic Tutor for just like another misstep or something. And, or I mean, I guess I don't have quite enough mana to Demonic Tutor for Ancestral. Let's see. Show and Tell. Oh, well that actually changes things quite a bit. Because now I can Demonic Tutor for Lotus and then have Show and Tell with Flusterstorm backup, which I think is pretty good. And if my opponent had to have found Force of Will to go along with actually, you know what? I haven't played a land yet. I could just get beside you. Yeah, that actually sounds way better. And then just pass the turn, and then I just cast Show and Tell with beside you up. And given that I have a Flusterstorm in hand, it's going to be hard for my opponent to really go off too hard here. Especially if they want to leave Pyroblast up. Though beside you, of course, makes things a little different. I don't think they fire off Ancestral without Pyroblast protection unless I play beside you, but given that I played the beside you, it makes it a lot more reasonable. I am, of course, going to Flusterstorm this. And I guess I get Trop Gland here. I do have an Ancient Grudge that I currently can't cast, but I think Trop is still a little better. Alright. Fluster Ancestral, leaving my opponent with a hand of Mana Drain, Pyroblast, Jace, Fast Bond, and one unknown, which is not gonna... That hand does not go off very easily. I guess if my opponent has Mana Crypt or Lotus, they can resolve Jace. But Crystal Brand Draw 7 is a pretty good way to beat Jace, even if it doesn't get bounced immediately. And there's a chance my opponent doesn't even have anything, and just, you know... Oh, there's the Mana Crypt. Never mind. Opponent didn't actually find Mana Crypt, which I think they... I mean, I guess they could have drawn either on that turn or the turn prior. Well, I'm still resolving Gristlebrand here, drawing 7, and I'm going to get to use Beside You plus Dig Through Time, I think, from the turn following that, even if Gristlebrand gets bounced. Cast Show and Tell off those manas. Cannot be countered. Hope my opponent doesn't put something great into play. Just the Fast Bond, sure. Draw 7. We did it. Alright, let's play Lotus. Mox. Time Walk, Dig Through Time. Yeah, I think that'll work. Let's cast Time Walk. And if my opponent has responses, then I might do something. Alright, nope, I don't think I need to dig here. I'm not going to need to use Beside You to cast this dig anyway. My opponent's out of counters, clearly. You don't let Time Walk resolve if you're not. Alright, let's attack Jace. Alright, well, this deck does get to do sweet things when it goes off, so there is that. So Jace dies, and then I get to cast Show and Tell, and I guess, I'm not even going to bother making it uncounterable. I don't think I need to do that. And then I get to put Omniscience into play, and then cast a Dig Through Time off of it. Boom. And find Emrakul, and the other card doesn't matter. Let's just take... Force of Will, sure. Alright. Beside You was pretty good there, though. I mean, I think I would probably have been fine if I just got Black Lotus. It just seems safer to get Beside You, so I didn't lose to a Force of Will. Alright. And let's go to sideboarding. Yeah, I don't think anything particularly changes. I mean, I don't want tons of oaths. I don't mind Ancient Grudge. I don't really want Decay. Ravenous Trap or anything like that. I mean, the Ravenous Trap's not how you actually fight gifts, so...